Hey folks, we're here again for the third annual Spring Grove Area School District Diversity Festival.
Joe, what we have today is I'm going to do some of the same things that we did last year. We have some spanakopita or spanakopita, however you like to say it. We have some Italian tiramisu, and I did some baklava, and here I'm sauteing some Jamaican jerk shrimp, which is Mr. Louie's favorite, so we have to have that on the menu. But one of the things that I'm struggling with today, Mr. Ituri, is all of these items were popular, but I'm kind of struggling. Like, I need one or two more items, and I don't know what to do.
Well, the good thing here is we have some student chefs right here, and I think we also have some distinguished guest judges, and what we're going to do here is break you into two teams for you folks to come up with your best appetizer dish. Yeah. You'll have 30 minutes to come up with it, and we will be the judges as we do our own Spring Grove Chop.
What a great idea. Just remember, we'll keep it to 30 minutes, and it has to be a diversity special theme. So think, you know, diverse, think authentic. And like I said, you have 30 minutes. Timer starts now. Go.
Welcome back to another gorgeous day at New Salem Elementary School.
This is Adam Herbst and Myra Spriggs reporting to you from the WNSC studio.
Today is Wednesday, March 13th, Cycle 21, Day 6.
Ms. Kalasak is here for library enrichment, Ms. Bortner is here for phys ed, and Mr. Bupp is here for instrument lessons.
Today's regular is hot chicken gravy over a whole grain bread with mashed potatoes and buttered corn.
The alternate is a turkey and cheese sandwich on a whole grain roll or a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Happy birthday wishes go out to Mackenzie Glatfelder, Luke Hess, Isabella Oquendu, Colton Pisano, and Ezekiel Riley.
Happy birthday! Temperatures will be in the low 50s with mostly sunny skies.
Check out this video to help us continue our celebration over Career Week.
If there's something you're passionate about, dare to turn it into a career. That's what New York artist Sean Kenny has done. Mr. Sean uses Lego pieces to design and create sculptures, books, and artwork for clients around the world.
Today, he's here at the Botanical Gardens in Naples, and we're gonna meet him.
We found Mr. Sean signing autographs for some of his fans. He's a popular guy, and no wonder, his sculptures are really awesome.
So there he is, the hummingbird. He's big.
How long did it take you to make that?
The hummingbird, he took about 6 weeks, and there were about two of us working on him at the same time. But more than the length of time, it was really hard to build it because it's so tall. We had to be up about 11 feet to build him. So we had step ladders on both sides of him while we were building, and we had a table underneath his belly with a big cart on top of it with all our Lego pieces on top of the cart. It was very complicated.
Wow, it took 31,565 pieces of Lego to make the hummingbird. Can you guess how many pieces to make this bison and calf?
Is this made completely out of Legos?
Well, it's not solid, if that's what you mean. No, they're hollow, and the walls of the bodies might be only about a half inch thick. Well, they would be far too heavy if they were solid, and it would take 10 times as many Lego pieces.
So, did you guess right? The mother bison is made with 45,143 pieces, and the calf 16,229.
What was your favorite activity to do when you were a kid?
Well, other than Lego, you mean? let's see, I actually really love to draw a lot. I was always drawing. I would do cartoons. I would make cartoons of my friends and my teachers. I've always been the complete Lego maniac. I always was when I was a little kid.
How did you start your career as a Lego certified professional?
Well, the cool thing is that I don't work for the Lego company. I'm just their best customer. And so, much like an artist who picks up a bunch of paint and buys some canvases and makes some things just because they want to, well, that's what I did. That's how I started.
Did anyone discourage you from making this career?
I don't think anyone ever did, actually. I had a lot of support from my family and from my wife, and that's always very helpful. You know, everybody that I met thought it was just really an awesome idea.
What would you say to kids who want to make a career out of something they love?
Well, like I was saying, practice makes perfect. It's corny, but it's true. But I think you really just need to have the confidence to step up and do something that you know you're good at and not be afraid of what people might have to say about it.
Practice definitely made perfect for Mr. Sean. His Lego sculptures are amazing.
Tonight is the fourth grade science fair from 6:30 to 7:30 in the cafeteria.
While you're visiting the science fair, be sure to also check out the PTO book fair from 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock in the gymnasium.
Friday is Discover Your Dress-Up Day, so begin to think about what you want to be when you grow up, and come to school dressed to impress.
Thank you for watching our podcast today at New Salem Elementary School.
We're on the house. Are you in the house?
Please rise for a moment of silence, followed by the playing of our national anthem and the pledge to the flag.